when I was writing the first volume, I was at Caltech, and I was advancing in the math department. I was still, you know, I was a mathematician. I didn't, and in the early 60s, as I said, I never would have believed that computer science, you know, or under any name, that there would be an academic discipline of this sort. However, at Stanford, George Forsythe had come, late 50s to Stanford, and he and very few other people had a vision that there was something here that ought to be a part of every university's curriculum, and it became known as computer science. And he, I consider him the father of computer science. And a wonderful man, he figured out a way to bring people to Stanford to build a department, and he started scrounged around the whole world, everybody that he felt would be the best in what he saw as this emerging field. He would invite them to Stanford and say, please come join us here. And so he recruited and operated on a shoestring. He had the support of Provost Al Bowker, who later became famous for many other things, including Chancellor of Berkeley. But Al Bowker was in Stanford administration and very supportive of Forsythe's ideas and giving him strategy on how to proceed. And so he was able to, even though there was no funding for this, he was able to get somebody to be part-time here, in math, somebody part-time in electrical engineering, somebody part-time at SLAC. More and more people, John McCarthy coming, so that he had the largest concentration of good computer scientists anywhere during the 1960s. Next week, our department is celebrating its 40th anniversary, and we're going to be reminiscing about this time, where it's actually the 41st anniversary, because the department began in 1965. They had, I don't know, half a dozen students, or 10 students or something at the very beginning, and then quite a few later on. But it was a pioneer in this area of doing computing. Now, I learned about the connection between computing and mathematics. I studied grammars, and I liked the idea that the grammar of a computer language could be studied with mathematical tools, and got into correspondence with Bob Floyd, who at the time was in Massachusetts, and I met him in the summer of '62 after I had written another compiler. I wrote a compiler for UNIVAC Corporation, and I met Bob in the fall of 1962, actually, and he introduced me to a brand new thing that you could actually prove things about computer programs. You could not only fiddle with a program and until it worked, you could develop a theory so that you would know that the program would work. This was a revelation. I never brought my mathematical side and my computer side together. Computer side, I just was an engineer fiddling. So Bob said, "No, Don, look at this. You can actually be sure that your computer program is working if you look at it the right way." This was a great revelation to me. So I got friendly with Bob. I visited him in Massachusetts. He visited me in California. And I began to see that maybe there was a possibility for an academic subject of computing. Forsythe invited me up to Stanford. My sister-in-law was living in San Francisco at the time, so it was a convenient time for us to come up and take a look at the campus, which was, of course, beautiful. And George said, "You know, okay, Don, join us." Oh, I said, no, I'm writing this book and I'm going to finish and my, you know, my son's going to be born. We got to have some stability. But I knew that at some point in my life, I'd have to make a decision where was going to be my permanent home instead of just, at this time, I'm an assistant professor. Caltech actually promoted me to associate professor after 2 or 3 years. I say something about tenure, I guess. About that time, there was a story in the Los Angeles Times. Students at UCLA were unhappy because a professor at UCLA hadn't gotten tenure. And I never heard of the word tenure before, so I went to Marshall Hall and I said, Marshall, what is this word tenure? What does it mean that she didn't get tenure? And he said, well, Don, remember when you got your appointment form from Caltech last year where it said you're appointed associate professor, you know? And I said, yeah. Well, there's a line on there. It says the ending date for your appointment. Remember that line was blank? And I said, yes. Well, he says, that's tenure. In other words, your job goes on. Well, I'd never heard of the concept before, so I had tenure before I knew it existed, and I'm glad because a lot of students now are so worried about not getting tenure that it interferes with their professional development, that they're spending more time strategizing about how to get tenure than about how to do good science.